This video, Isometric Drawings Practice, is asking us to sketch three different solids on isometric dot paper. And we use this isometric dot paper to draw two-dimensional views of a three-dimensional figure to give it some three-dimensional qualities. And you've all done this before. It's just drawing cubes that look three-dimensional. But we do have to follow some guidelines when we're doing these. Sometimes this is called a corner view or a perspective view, but all of them are going to have three different measures. We're going to have a front measure, we're going to have a height, and we're going to have a right measure. And so I'm going to keep on referencing those as we go through these drawings. For this first one, a cube with an edge of four, I'm going to show you the finished drawing first, and then I'm going to walk you through it. This is what the cube will look like. And again, I'm going to just write the words down here, front, height, and right. And we're going to put in the values for each of these. Because this is a cube, all of those measures are going to be the same. The front measure is going to be 4, the height is going to be 4, and the right is going to be 4. And I'm going to draw this and walk you through it, but let's just label this on our finished cube here. This value right here, or this edge right here, represents the front measure. That's our F. This edge represents our right, and that again is 4, is our right measure. And then the height is always going to be that vertical distance. That, of course, is 4, and that's our height. And as we get into some more difficult ones, you want to keep those values straight. And so I would recommend that you write out front, height, and right before you start these. There's several different ways you can approach starting these. I always like to start at this bottommost point here, do my front line, my right line, and my height line. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. You want to keep in mind that what the end product will look like to make sure you give yourself enough room. If I'm going to start at this point, I'm just going to start down here. Pick that bottom point and then start with a V. And what I mean by that, I'm going to do the front of 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I'm going to do my right of 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and that forms a V. You don't have to label these. I'm just going to do that to show you I use my front and my right. And then after I make that V, I go ahead and add the height from that start point, a height of 1, 2, 3, 4. You want to follow the dots on these, and once you have this starting V with the vertical height, it's a lot easier to finish it off. On these prisms, we're always going to have three vertical heights. We have the vertical height we drew, and then we're going to have this vertical height and this vertical height. So if we start with this V with the line up the middle, then we can add the other vertical height of 4 from that endpoint, a vertical height of 4 from this endpoint, and then you'll see that we're kind of bringing things together here. From there, you just finish it off however you like. You know that this edge, this right edge, is going to be parallel to this right edge, so that's easy to just connect the dots. This front edge is going to be parallel to connect the dots up here. And now we just finish off the top, and you realize up here that I do have to make that top into a cube shape as well. So I'm just going to follow the parallel pieces here. From this edge, I'm going to go out 1, 2, 3, 4, and then from this edge, I'm going to connect that last piece of 4. You do not have to finish off with all these grids here. Some people like to do that, to just add in those lines all the way along. This is certainly fine as your finished product. If you want to fill in kind of a dashed line to give it that three-dimensional feel, you certainly can do that. not needed, but just that basic cube is all you need. So let's go ahead and look at the next. We're asked to draw a rectangular prism, 1 unit high, 5 units long, and 4 units wide. So I'm going to start by writing down my front height and my right. That's a good place to start. The height is going to be 1 unit high, so I'm going to fill that in first. And then it doesn't matter which way is which, really, unless they give you specifics. I'm going to say my front is 4 and my right is 5. And so it's 4 by 1 by 5. And again, I'm going to show you the finished drawing and then walk you through it again. If you want to try to draw this on your own first, go ahead and pause the video. Otherwise, we'll just walk through it together. This is what this rectangular prism will look like when it's drawn. I'm going to go ahead and do my front height right up here to remind us what we're doing. We said 4 by 1 by 5. And again, I'm going to start at that bottommost point, giving myself lots of room down here. I'm going to pick this as my bottommost point. And then I'm going to start with the front. The front is always the left part of the V, so I'm going to go up 1, 2, 3, 4. That matches this right here. This is my front. And then I'm going to do the V using the right. This is my right. I'm going to go up 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then I'm going to finish off. My height is just going to be 1 unit high, so I go up 1. From here, I like to do the other two vertical heights from the endpoints. I'm going to go up 1. I'm going to go up 1. And then I can go ahead and connect all the parallel edges. Since this is 5, I'm going to connect these 2 points, and that's a distance of 5. I'm going to connect these 2 points. That's a distance of 4 if you want to count that out. And then just like before, we're going to finish it off by going all the way out and connecting the pieces. And I can be finished just like this. I don't have to add any dimension or add in the cubes or anything like that. I don't have to label it. That's my finished product. The last one is the trickier one. It's a triangular prism. So it's still going to be a prism with 2 bases, but those bases are going to be triangles. And specifically, they're right triangles. But again, I'm going to start out by putting in my front height and right. Again, the front and the right don't matter as much, but I know it's 3 units high. That's given to me first. And then my front, I'm going to say, is the 4. And my right, 6 units long, is 6. So it's going to be 4 by 3 by 6. And I'm going to once again just show you what it looks like and then walk through it. So if you want to try this out, go ahead and pause the video. Otherwise, this is what it's going to look like, and I'm going to walk through it with you. Remember, it's a triangular prism, and so we have 2 triangle bases. And so let's just walk through how we start this. We said it was 4 by 3 by 6, front height right, 4, 3, 6. And I'm going to start with this bottommost point. Give yourself lots of room. I'm going to just start right here. I'm going to do my front of 4 from that point. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm starting out just like before. So I did my front. Next, I'm going to do my right of 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm starting out with that V. And then my height, of course, I'm going to go up from that starting point, a value of 3. 1, 2, 3. So we're starting just like before, and we're going to continue just like before of adding in those vertical pieces from the endpoint. Remember, my height is 3, so from my endpoints, I can go up 3 and up 3. And again, I can connect those edges so that they are parallel to those bottom edges. And so now if I finish this off as a rectangular prism, I would connect it like I did before like this, so it showed that that base was a rectangle. But remember, we want a triangle base, and so this is the only time where we're going to cut across those dots and not follow the natural line that we've been following of these dots. We're going to cut across and connect these two points to make the triangle base. And so when I do that, it seems kind of weird because I'm just going across the dots, but that gives me that triangular base. Remember, it's a right triangle. So you want to go ahead and put the right triangle symbol in there, the perpendicular symbol, and I can do it on that bottom piece as well. In this one, it's not necessary, but it's a good idea to add the dimension of that bottom triangle piece. So then it's clear to see that we have the bottom triangle base and the top triangle base because it's a triangular prism. Remember, prism means you have two bases that are in the shape of a triangle. We'll have more practice on this on our next set of videos and in your homework.